Hi, today we are going to learn about explaining the angle relationships when a parallel line is cut by a transversal. Let's look at a problem. Solve. We have lines R and T cut by a transversal Q and the angles formed are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. It's given that lines R and T are parallel. We need to know what is the relationship between angle 5 and angle 6. This is angle 5 and this is angle 6. Both are lying on a straight line. And if we add angle 5 and angle 6, if you see measure of angle 5 plus measure of angle 6, it will come out to be 180 degrees. Why? Angles on a straight line form a linear pair. This implies that angle 5 and angle 6 are supplementary. So, D supplementary is our answer option. Next problem. Solve. Lines R and T are parallel. What is the relationship between angle 3 and angle 1? This is angle 3 and this is angle 1. This is line R and this is the transversal Q. This is angle 3 and this is angle 1. Both are lying on the opposite side of the intersection. This is the intersection. When the angles are lying on the opposite sides of the intersection, they are known as vertically opposite angles. And vertically opposite angles are always congruent. They are always congruent. So we can say B congruent is our answer. Next problem. Solve. Lines R and T are parallel. What is the relationship between angle 4 and angle 6? This is angle 4. This is angle 6. Consider them both are lying inside the parallel lines and on the opposite side of the transversal. This is 4 and this is 6. When lines are lying inside the parallel lines and on the opposite sides of transversal, they are known as alternate interior angles. And they are always congruent. So, B congruent is our answer option. I hope you can practice more problems on explaining the angle relationships when a parallel line is cut by a transversal. Thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.